What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Donnie here, out working on the Goldwing today. It's another beautiful day here in spring Texas. Blue sky, clouds are rolling in now. It's about 3 p.m, but earlier today was this clear blue sky, 75 degrees, beautiful riding weather. And instead of riding motorcycles today, like I should be, I'm out here working on them. But wanted to do a video, on my Goldwing that I've had for about a month now. It's a 1997 SE Goldwing that I bought. And kind of unexpectedly at the time when I got it, I mean, I'd been looking and knew that I was going to get a Goldwing eventually, but when I came upon this one, I ended up getting one quicker than I expected to. But anyway, let's take care of some housekeeping here before I get started. And if you don't want to listen to any of this, you can just fast forward through it to the parts that you want to look at and hear. But first of all, excuse my garage. It is a complete disaster. Just a mess in here, stuff all around, patio furniture and boxes been in there for a few years, and I need to put stuff away and get reorganized. This I had my garage so organized a year ago or so, and nice and clean, and could work in it real good, but it's just gotten out of control. But anyway, because I got this Goldwing, you know, I had to make room in my garage with the way it is, and because I also have another toy, I've got a 02 C5 Corvette convertible that I drive for fun on beautiful days like this. So that's another toy I've got. So I keep that parked in the garage at all times. And then I had my Harley over here, which I have a 2003 Harley Davidson Road King 100th Anniversary Gold Key Edition. Beautiful bike. I used to park it right here, but because I got the Goldwing, I had to move it up, get some room in the garage so I could park the Goldwing over here. So anyway, it's a disaster, but I want to make a video today over a couple things that I've done to the bike so far and what I'm going to be doing to the bike since I've got it. Like I said, I got it maybe just over a month ago, and I did a video that's on my channel, a tour of the bike when I got it. But there's some things that I want to do to it, just getting it up to par, like putting certain things on it and then doing like some service items to it since it is a 97, it's several years old now and quite old. And I just want to start fresh with everything on the bike. So even though the guy that I bought it from, it's a one owner bike, the guy that I bought it from took damn good care of it, and it has about 63,000 miles on it. But you know, he rode it, him and his wife, they traveled all over and went on many trips, and he kept detailed mileage records, how many miles they drove and what the gas mileage he got, all the service he had done to it. But you know, this is 97, and he got it in February of 98, but in 2013, you know, as they got older, he was 70 when I just bought it from him. He's 70 years old now. In 2013, they quit riding. And so it wasn't ridden a whole lot. It was started up and ridden around his neighborhood and stuff. But basically quit riding the bike. So he quit putting miles on. The only thing that he did to it was, you know, change the oil occasionally. So that means all the other things, coolant, brake fluids, you know, spark plugs, all that type of stuff, the serviceable stuff, the filters, these little elements, things like that. You know, the last time he did it, yeah, it had fresh stuff and he kept it up to par, but that was 2013, since the last stuff that's been done to it like that. So that's 10 years ago. So I want to go through the whole bike, start fresh on everything that I can change, do, and service. And then I'm going to, once I have all that done, I'm going to take it to a shop, have new tires put on it and wheel bearings put on it when they drop the rims and stuff. But anyway, so I wanted to make a video and talk about that. And I just want to let people know, first of all, you know, about my channel. So first, well, let me back up. when I bought this bike, or when I was looking to get a Goldwing, this fourth generation like this, I, you know, was searching on the internet, and I was watching YouTube videos and people showing their bikes and working on them and how to do stuff and taking it on, taking their bikes on rides and stuff. And I loved all those videos. And, you know, I have a YouTube channel, and obviously if you're watching this, you're here at my channel. But the first video I did on my Goldwing a month or so ago, it's got over 1,000 views. And so that tells me that, that people are out there doing the same thing I did. They're looking at these fourth generation Goldwings, and they want to see videos about them and see what's out there, what people done to them, how to service them, do that. Now, my channel, I'm not about that, okay? I'm not trying to monetize my channel. My channel is basically for me. And my friends or whoever wants to check things out, whoever wants to come to my channel, but I don't promote my channel. I don't send out links all over necessarily on the internet or Facebook or however you get your channels out there. I don't do all that because I'm not trying to monetize it. So basically, like I said, the channel is for me, and it's something that I do. So when I get older, if I live to be quite older, I can look back at these videos and smile and have a good laugh and look at myself when I was younger. And, you know, in other videos, I do put myself out there, but here I am right here, because I didn't show my face, I think, in my other Goldwing video. But, you know, like I said, the channel is for me, so I can look back and look at myself, things I've done, videos I've done. Or when I'm dead and gone and leave this earth, you know, my friends and my family can look back and watch me on YouTube or whatever, or whoever else, you know, comes across it. When I'm dead and gone, I'm there forever, as long as the YouTube's around or whatever. You know, who knows what this world's going to be decades from now. So I'm just doing stuff for my own enjoyment and fulfillment. Like I said, not trying to monetize anything, not trying to get all kinds of views, but just trying to make videos in case people do searches for things that, certain things, you know, most of my channel is country music, live bands, and country western dancing and stuff. So, and I've put a couple albums on there that artist albums out there that were hard to find, that I was the first one to put them out there. You know, and stuff like that. And then I did some motorcycle things, some stuff with my Harley, just stuff for me personally. So if you're here on my channel, and you're probably here for the Goldwing stuff, and this is my second one, so for the Goldwing, and I appreciate you stopping in. And if you want to subscribe, but again, I'm not trying to, you know, blow it up or get views or monetize or anything like that. Okay. It's just a personal thing for me. I know I keep saying that, but it is. So what I want to do today is like I said, I want to kind of go over what I've already done to the bike, which isn't a whole lot, and then talk about what I'm going to do before I take it to a shop to have the tires and the wheel bearings done. Now, there are a lot of good videos, people out there that are doing videos on the fourth generation Goldwings. With the fourth generations are 1988 through 2000. And one of the channels that I came across is Herbie's Garage. Now, he has a 97, a red one, like, 97 just like mine. And this is an Aspencade. And he's done several videos, timing belts and all that, and different things, you know, headlights and replacing bulbs and stuff like that, service things, and real good videos. And there's a few others out there that have done videos on some of the same stuff. So I'm not, my videos when I do this, these aren't going to be step-by-step videos of how to do stuff, fix stuff. I'm going to do videos showing you what I did to it, or what I'm going to do to it, or what I'm going to fix or replace. And it's not a how-to step-by-step. So don't, you know, watch my channel wasting your time thinking I'm going to show you how to fix something or whatever, because that's not what I'm going to do. I just want to showcase the bike for people that are, you know, get lost in YouTube land, or they're looking at looking for fourth generation Goldwing videos, and they have, you know, here's another video that they can look at if they're interested. So I'm going to go over some of the stuff that I've done, but real quick, I want to mention too that on the first video I did, you know, it's got about 1,085 views right now, which kind of, it's not a lot. That's not a lot of views to me, but it's kind of surprising that people are coming, you know, Googling this and they're finding my video and they're coming and checking it out, which is great because that's what I had been doing before when I was on the search for one of these bikes. And I appreciate all the videos that people did do, test drives or riding, doing their rides or their mechanic work or whatever. And I had just like 3 comments on my channel. And I talked about on the first video that I've got a Harley and blah, 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 03 Road King. And again, I'll show it. So this is my first touring bike right here. This is a 2003, like I said, Harley Davidson Road King Anniversary Edition, Gold Key Anniversary Edition. Beautiful bike, runs damn good. It's been just wonderful for me. I got this bike in 2010. And of course, here we are in 2023. She's still running. I do all the maintenance and stuff basically myself. Take it to shops to have the tires done and stuff like that. But most of the maintenance and serviceable stuff, that, you know, I try to do that work. So, you know, there was a guy that commented on my first GoldWing video when I mentioned that, you know, I've got a Harley and the Harley guys and friends are going to give me hell because I got a GoldWing. And he put down a comment like, quit talking about that Harley, that's junk, and you need to get rid of it. And I'm like, okay, this is crazy. Like, I'm not here to, I'm not one of those guys that bashes other bikers. I, you know, it doesn't matter to me what kind of bike you ride. Absolutely doesn't matter to me. All that matters is that you're out there riding your motorcycle, whatever you got, enjoying life, enjoying the bike, going on trips, and you're out there riding. Whether it's a sport bike, a touring bike, a chopper, whatever you got, metric, American, whatever. I'm just not one of those guys to bash people. And the funny thing is, you know, yes, I've been riding this Harley, and when I go to biker bars or when I do bring it to a shop, people are looking at this bike. They want to buy this bike because they haven't seen a 03 Anniversary Edition this clean. And I've got the colored matching bags on it, that because really a Road King Classic has the black leather bags, which I still got. And but these are off of this is the matching that matches the color off of an Ultra Classic of the same year. And I've got the gold rims off of a Classic, so I don't have the spoke wire. So it's somewhat unique for a Road King Classic. So I get offers of people wanting to buy it, or they love looking at it. You know, like I said, I pull up at a place where there's motorcycles and heads start turning, and I get off, I go in, get a drink, get something to eat. People are walking by, they're looking at my bike because it's a 03 Gold Key Anniversary Edition, and this is the flagship, that's the flagship color scheme. So it is a beautiful bike. I've taken this bike right here from Spring, Texas, rode all the way to Michigan and back, 3,700 mile round trip, not one issue, not one problem. So for somebody to tell me that a Harley is junk or whatever, that's just, you know, maybe they're haters or they don't know what they're talking about. I don't know if they've ever ridden a Harley, you know, and when I say Harley, I'm talking about, I'm only interested in touring bikes at my age. I had the crotch rockets back in the day, Honda CBR, Suzuki Quintana, all, you know, several different ones. In my young days, I'm all about touring bikes. I'm an old man now, getting up there. And you know, I want to go on a 2-hour drive for lunch and have a nice ride, not race, sit back, stretch out, be comfortable. That's what it's about, enjoying the ride. So I'm interested in touring bikes. So when it comes to Harley, I'm not out there looking at all these other kinds of Harleys. I just like a Harley Road Kings and above, Street Glide, Ultra Classics, Road Glide, those kinds. And then the Goldwing, I've always loved the Goldwing. And like I said in the first video, Goldwing is the king of touring bikes. That's a fact. That's, you know, could be opinion too, but they're known as the Cadillac. They are the king of touring bikes, the Cadillac of touring bikes, no doubt about it. That bike right there is just the king. Even though it's a 97, it is still the king. But, you know, again, this guy is like bashing me on a comment that I should stop talking about my Harley No, I'm not. And don't be one of those guys. Be a motorcyclist, okay? Don't bash people for what they ride. They're out there on two wheels, enjoying life, having a good time. There's lots of interesting bikes out there. There's lots of fun to be had on all kinds of bikes, even dirt bikes. I started at 8 years old on a dirt bike. That's how I learned how to drive stick shifts, because I rode a dirt bike at 8 years old with a clutch and gears, and I understood the concept of using a clutch and gears. When I got old enough to drive cars, I knew how to drive a stick shift because I under, you know, even though you're doing the clutch differently and it's a car and the motorcycle shifting differently, different the way you do it's different with your hands and your feet, but it's the same concept. So, you know, dirt bikes and all kinds of bikes, they're fun. So don't be one of those people that's a hater and a basher because of what you ride. And I think the funny thing is too, is I told June, my girlfriend, that I'm gonna love to pull up on my at the biker bars and stuff, pull up on my Goldwing and be wearing all my Harley stuff, my Harley t-shirts and my Harley gloves, and because I'm gonna be dressing just like I wear my Harley, whatever I've been riding my Harley with, that's gonna what I'm gonna ride my Goldwing with. So, you know, I'll pull up to these bars where the majority will be Harley bikes or Indians or whatever, and here I'm, Donnie comes, I'm pulling up on my old Goldwing and I'm getting off and I've got Harley Davidson t-shirts. It's gonna be hilarious to see the looks on people's faces. I can't wait. But anyway, so I just wanted to take care of all that kind of housekeeping stuff about my channel, my personal views on bikes, the comment that I got about my Harley being junk and don't talk about it and whatever. And okay, whatever. Now we're past all that. Now let's get into my bike, what I've done, and what I'm going to do. So let's start off with the headlights up front. So thanks to Herbie's Garage, you know, when I got this bike, it had the old halogen headlights and the old little bitty bulbs, the position lights on the sides here, had the old halogen lights. They were all yellow, terrible looking, as we all know, just old technology. And the headlight on the glass, or this plastic right here, whatever you want to call it, you'd turn it on and almost immediately that thing would be burning hot. I mean, it would be cooking your hand, especially if after it was on for several minutes, that thing would be hotter than hell. Because I think the guy that had it before me, he put in some brighter halogen bulbs, stronger ones, and they were even hotter than probably the original ones. So they were just super hot and yellow. And when I drove out in the country one night in the dark, pitch dark in the country roads, you know, I had to have the high beams on a lot because it just didn't put out that much light. It was like I said, it was dim and it was yellow. So, you know, I got this thing and I started looking around like, okay, I'm gonna have to get some LED headlights, because that's one of the things I did on my 03 Road King, is I changed out the my three light, the headlights and the passing lights on the side. I changed them out to LED. Now on the Harley, you know, I got the whole, not just the bulbs, but the whole lenses and everything. They come as a kit where you change the whole assemblies out, and man, that thing, man, it just lights up the dark like you wouldn't believe. So first thing I told myself is I've got to get some LED lights up front. Now the bike does have some LED bulbs already on it from the previous owner, like the side lights on the saddlebags and all that. Some of those are LED bulbs, and then a lot of the other little bulbs, they're still halogen. And I'm eventually going to get to those bulbs and change them out to LED. But I wanted to immediately, almost immediately, I wanted to focus on the headlights and the position lights. So, you know, as I researched, as I done my research, you know, the name Pathfinder's out there. So I'm thinking, okay, Pathfinder, look them up. I think they were, I don't know what it was, $100, $120 for the Pathfinder bulbs. And then for another $40 or $50, you could get the bulbs for the position lights. And I was like, okay, you know, I don't know if I want to spend that much on bulbs, because you can't, as far as I know, I look, this assembly, they don't make an updated changeable assembly that's all LED. It's just the bulbs that you're replacing themselves. So I didn't want to spend that kind of money on just bulbs. So thanks to Herbie's Garage, I looked at one of his videos where he put in some LED bulbs, and he bought these bulbs that he got from another user on YouTube that uses these bulbs on his motorcycles, and then he bought the same brand bulbs, put them in his Goldwing, and he loves them. He said they work good. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna buy those, because they were like, each bulb was like $20, so $40 for the headlights, for the headlight, two headlight bulbs, $40, which is, you know, really cheap. But the one thing I noticed is that the Pathfinders, they have the heat sink or the heat dissipators or whatever on the back of them, and then they have a cord that comes off of them, I think, and then the plug on the end. And but these bulbs here are just like the halogen bulbs. They're the same exact setup, the base and everything, as the halogen bulbs, but with LED bulbs. Okay, there's no cord, there's no big heat fins on the end of them. And I thought, well, you know, what are these bulbs gonna do? Are they gonna crap out? They gonna burn up? They gonna, you know? And I thought, you know what, this Herbie guy, he put them on, and then after a year he did a review of his bike, all the things he did, and he made a comment about the lights again, that he loved them. So after a year using them, he didn't have no issues. Now, one of the issues that I did read is that some LED bulbs could have interference with your radio, making static noise or kinds of noise interference in your stereo sometimes, and you might have to get some sort of little filters on there, which Pathfinder did sell too. But you know, you had to chance it, like, okay, are these going to make noise on mine or not? So luckily the bulbs I bought, they didn't make any noise on my stereo, and they've been working great. And let me tell you, they're nice and bright. They're white light. They're very cool. I mean, there's no heat, doesn't get hot on the front of the lenses or anything. And it just made the bike look so much better, can see so much better, which is the most important thing. But also, you know, takes that old age look away, when the dim yellow look to nice bright white light that you can see, and it stays nice and cool up front. It's just not hot up front when you touch or when you put your hand up there. So I wanted to show those lights to y'all, or go over what they are. So let me put my glasses on here so I can read. So here they are. This is what Herbie got. These are Auto One. And I think when he bought his, I got these on Amazon like he did, but when he bought his, he bought the ones that were for the, for cars. So his were a two pack. It was one package with two headlights in it, but the same thing. So, when I was researching it, I think the two pack at the time was like $38 and some change. And then when I went back to buy them a few days later, a week later, they were like $10 more, over $40. So the price had changed. But they had the same bulb, which they're calling the motorcycle LED bulb, which is the exact same bulb in the two-pack car headlight. They had these individually for $19.99, I think. So if I look on my sheet here that I had, you know, they were $19.99 each, and they're the H4s. H4, when you change the bulbs out, they have to be H4, so they're compatible. So I put them in. They work great. I like them. They're no interference with the radio, and I haven't had any issues with them. I've ridden the bike a lot so far, and especially at night, because that's when I want to do the real testing, and out in the country where there's no light around whatsoever. And they're great. And so, you know, I'll just say this. When you start buying anything and you go on Amazon and you look at reviews and all this stuff, you get a mix of reviews. There's going to be something negative about anything you can possibly buy on the internet. And a lot of that's just personal opinion, in my opinion. And so I always, I want to see videos of not somebody's opinion or what they wrote on a review. I want to see videos of, okay, did you put this on your bike? Did you actually use it? I want to see you use it. What do you got to say about it? And I want to come across people that I feel are trustworthy and are given the truth. And so I know that, Herbie's Garage, that guy, he sounds like an old country boy, and he knows what the hell he's talking about on bikes. He fixes multiple motorcycles. And I said, you know what? If it worked for him and he's using them, and a year later he says they're working great, no issues. Well, hey, they're good enough for him. I'm gonna get them. And I paid $40 instead of $120. So hell of a savings right there. So I'm just one of those guys that's gonna sometimes I'm gonna chance it. I'm not gonna go by the reviews. I'm not gonna go by the threads of, oh, you gotta get Pathfinder, and that's the way to go. And okay, that's your opinion, fine. And I was gonna get the Pathfinders, but I didn't want to pay that for the bulbs. I'm trying to keep my costs down on this bike, and so I got these, and they're working great. No interference on the radio, no nothing. Everything's working great. So that's the headlights. Now let's talk about the position lights, which are these right here on the sides of the headlights. Again, they had little bitty bulbs in them that were yellow and hot, and they are the T10 or the 194s. Those are the sizes of the bulbs when you go to buy bulbs. That specific bulb in there is a T10 or a 194. So that's what you need to look for. So on, and Pathfinder wanted 40 or $50 for two of those bulbs, little bitty bulbs. And I was like, they're nuts. So again, on Amazon, there are a buttload of LED bulbs that you can buy. So I got on some, I can't even think of the channel's name now. There's a guy on YouTube that did a video about all the, he was changing out, he had his bike all apart, and he's swapping over to LED, changing out all the bulbs, and he talks about the numbers and stuff. So I had to get down in the comments. He listed some of the part numbers and where he got them on Amazon, this, that, and the other. So I hit one of his links, and I came up with these bulbs. So instead of getting those $40, $50 Pathfinder lights for the position lights for the side here, what I did was I clicked on his link, and it brought me to this pack here. I don't know how you say that name right there, but I got a 20-piece set of these super bright lights, okay? A bag of them, 20 bulbs for $11.99 for 20 of these things. So I was like, wow, okay. So they come in, and I get them, and let me see, what was the package in? Oh yeah, comes in a pack like this right here. So here they are. There's a pack of them, came in this box. It came in this box right here, and then in this package. Maybe it's a anti-static electricity pack, and 20 bulbs for $12. And here's the little bulb right here. See if I can get this to focus. Here's the little bulb right there. It's got LEDs every which way. Damn thing don't want to focus. Every which way around it and on the tip. So, and there's all kinds of designs on these 194s and different makers, designs, whatever. And people have opinions on that too. What, oh, you should get with this one and not that one and blah, blah, blah. Okay, whatever. So $12. Hey, I'm going to buy a pack for $12. And if they don't work out, well, then I'll buy some other ones. No big deal. So I've got them in. And now we're going to take a look at how these things look. So let me turn the lights on here. So I know I don't have a before with the yellow lights, but here they are. Not and you know, it's not showing up that good on the camera in my garage as being the nice how bright white they are. I mean, I can already tell on the camera, but trust me, these things are super white, bright, beautiful light. I mean, just 100%, 100, 360, 180 degree, whatever you want to call it, difference than what was on this bike when I bought it, which was halogen bulbs. These bulbs made a difference. So the two up here are the, of course, the headlight, the auto ones, and then the ones on the side again are the 20 piece set that I bought for $12. There they are. I mean, they're the same color, same matching up as the as the headlight. Now you can get these things in different colors, or the way the lighting is, you know, natural light or whatever they call it. But I got the, you know, I got the, whenever I get these things, I got the XENON. I don't know how the hell you say that, but anyway, that's the bulbs that I got. You know, you'll have different ones that you can buy that put off, like I said, I don't know if it's natural or bright or whatever, but that XENON are the ones that I got. And I'm going to get those same kind of bulbs when I do the blinkers and the side markers, because they do make them in colored bulbs. So anywhere I have the yellow, I'm going to get yellow bulbs, just like that. Anywhere I have red, I'm going to get red bulbs. Even though with the halogen, the way this sits now, the bulbs are clear and then the lens makes the color. But if you get the color bulbs, it's gonna make it even look that much more awesome. So that's the bulb part of this. That's my what I did for my bike. Hopefully, you know, this helps. And I'm not trying to push any kind of brands. I'm not trying to do any of that stuff. I'm trying to keep costs down. That's what I'm trying to do. This is a, you know, this is a 97 bike. It's old. I don't want to spend a whole bunch of money fixing this thing up or modding this thing up. I want to keep costs down. I don't want to buy junk parts, but I don't need top of the line or somebody's been, oh, Pathfinder's the best. If you don't have Pathfinder, you don't know what the hell you're talking about. No, I don't think so, buddy. You know, so there are tons of brands out there on bulbs. You just, you know, you might just have to take a chance if you don't like the ones I got, or whatever your opinion is. If you want, there's another brand out there, or you have some brighter ones or cheaper ones or whatever's out there on Amazon. You know, sometimes you just got to buy it and try it. And if you got something and didn't work out, you just got to eat the cost. And then, hey, at least you got firsthand real world experience. And that's what I'm here trying to do. Herbie's Garage, he suggested these lights. He tried them. He had them on there a year. Worked great. And I said, you know what? I'm going to do the same thing then. Cheap, and I'm glad I did. I'm glad I didn't do the Pathfinder. So let's talk about another thing that I did on my bike when it comes to the stereo, okay? I wanted to get the stereo plays fine on that. It's got the cassette deck on here, and the stereo, the radio stations and all that play fine. But I wanted to, there's a lot of, I'm stumbling around here and mumbling, but first of all, let me show you something else. I got my phone, mount right here, which is on the 1-inch ball mount right here, which goes on the, by the grip here, by the choke. Screwed in, and I got the RAM mount, a little extra large RAM mount, so I got that, holds my phone, and then I'm eventually going to do the other side, get a cup holder here, and there's several different makes and models of the cup holder, but I got to figure out which one I like, which one I want, and, you know, how much they are. I'm not going to get crazy. I don't think I'm going to spend, you know, I'm not going to spend $80-$90 for a cup holder necessarily, unless it's the one I like, but there's some expensive ones out there. But that seems awful excessive for a cup holder. But anyway, what I am going to talk about is how I'm doing Bluetooth on my stereo for this bike. Okay, so I thought about, you know, playing stereo on my phone here, but now I'm thinking, how am I gonna do this when I'm videoing and play it on my phone? So now I got to get my other phone here and Bluetooth it up. But let me show you what I did. And I did the same thing. I know I'm babbling here, and excuse me for all this, but I kind of just realized how stupid I am that I'm not going to be able to play music on my phone from my phone while I'm making a video here. So I got my other phone out here. So I'm going to have to do it on the Bluetooth. But, you know, I watched people on YouTube. They got a Bluetooth adapter to put it in the tape player. And I'm like, okay, why would I do that? I don't want the gears and stuff turning in that thing. And I know this tape player works. Well, some of y'all's tape players might not be working. And even though mine's working, I really don't want this thing grinding away on the inside, playing on a tape mechanism in there just to get Bluetooth through my phone. So what I bought for my bike, and y'all might already know this, I don't know, but for those who don't, I'm going to show it to you. So, and I've got the same thing on my Corvette, because my Corvette's an O2, and it doesn't, of course, doesn't have any Bluetooth stuff. So what I did is I bought an FM transmitter. Now, you can get these things on Amazon for less than $20. There's all kinds of different makes and models, and under $20, you can get an FM transmitter. And they're cool, and the sound quality is pretty damn good. Now, like I said earlier, I'm into country music, live music, so I'm a stickler when it comes to sound. I notice when the sound, when there's a variance in sound or it doesn't sound good, it's not tweaked, it's not mixed right. So, you know, these FM transmitters, they don't sound as good as a CD necessarily. Like my Vet, I've got a CD player in there, so I do have some CDs that I made. And when I put the CD in there, I've got a little bit more bass, a little bit more crisp sound. And the FM transmitter is not as crisp, but it's still good enough, and good enough for me. And if it's good enough for me, it's going to be good enough for most people, because most people aren't keen to the sound like I am on that type of stuff, technical stuff about how the actual crisp sound is. So these FM tuners, they're great. And less than $20, you can get these things. And so what I did on my bike is, I put the guy that I bought it from, I already have the 12 volt, outlet right here. Like the cigarette lighter type outlet, he already had that in the bike. So what I did is I bought dual socket power thing. So you plug it into the 12 volt plug, and it comes out two 12 volt things, two cigarette lighter type things. So in one, I've got a double USB power that I can plug my phone cord into. So when I got my phone, I can power my phone up. And then I have, and then it's got two USBs if I need to plug another cord in there for whatever reason. But in the other socket, I have this right here, an FM transmitter. And this thing just has a short little neck on here that plugs into the socket right here. And then it has the volume key on here, but you don't really control this, because this, you can control the volume. You want the volume on your phone all the way up to max, so then the stereo, and then control the stereo on your car or on your motorcycle here. But you want your phone volume up all the way, and which is this knob right here, is you can control it on your phone. Now this thing, well, it's an FM transmitter, so you set your stereo to an FM station that's not used. I think I do like 89.7 or whatever it is. And not only will it play music, but you could take calls on this thing. So when your phone rings, you're talking through your speakers and stuff in your car or on the motorcycle. You know, I really don't want to be using your phone while you're riding a motorcycle. But it has the capability, so it just doesn't play music. You could take calls and stuff. And less than $20. Now, I can't remember the brand of this one. It's the same one I had in my Corvette. But like I said, there's all kinds of different looks and brands and models, and really cheap. And so now I want to show you how this thing works. Now, again, this might be something, you know, you already know about, or maybe you don't really care about, but I wanted to show you the other, because I haven't seen anybody talk about this option. on these Gold Wings. They're like talking about getting the tape player thing, which I don't, like I said, I don't want this mechanism running. So I'm not doing Wi-Fi through the tape deck. I do not want this thing running. I don't want the gears inside turning, nothing. And then I've seen people take the whole unit off. They're trying to put in a another port or an auxiliary port or a Bluetooth module, like onto the, like solder it or put it on the unit, taking all this apart. I'm like, no. So I haven't seen anybody talk about FM transmitter. And that's why I'm bringing this up, because I don't know if it's because people don't like them or maybe people just don't know about them, because I really didn't know about these one day till I started Googling about my Corvette, what I could do. And then I was like, what the hell is this contraption? I never heard of this. And so I started telling my friends about it. My brother, they're like, oh yeah, we know about those. And so I didn't, and I came across it. Now I just want you to know about it. So let me see if I can get this thing going from my other phone here, and we'll see how this thing works. Now let's get some power to the bike. Got the stereo on. Flip some power to this, my little talk. All right. See that? I got a separate.
Waiting for connection.
I got a separate
power. Bluetooth connection success.
It says connection success, but it's connected to this phone. So let's see what I can get playing here. But I'm gonna put this on my other phone and see if we can get it going. Yeah. So then, Bluetooth it. Available devices. I might have to, let me stop this video and fix my phone, turn my Bluetooth off on this phone. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So now let me start over on this. So I've got the guy that I bought it from had these power things up here. So I got a switch for my I got the Ring of Fire up front on the front tire. Switch for that. Then a switch to turn the power outlet on and off. You see that? Off, on.
Normal voltage.
Normal voltage. And then another
Waiting this connection.
This thing was for a radar detector. But so you turn this thing on, it talks to you, normal connection. I got it set for 89.7. So you got to set the, find a station that's not being used, FM station. So I have it, 89.7 is what I use. And then you set your stereo to 89.7 on your car, your motorcycle, whatever you're using it on. And then now I got my other phone right here. So it's looking for it. So let's see if I can connect to this thing. See what happens here. Or pairing. Okay.
Bluetooth connection success.
We got success. So there it is. It's playing. So like I said, it's kind of low right now, but I'm going to turn my volume all the way up. There it is.
That's just Jesse.
Oh yeah, some good old country music right there. You might not like country music, but like I said, my channel has a bunch of country music on it. But so I just wanted to point that out. There, I've got my phone working on my motorcycle through a little FM transmitter that was less than $20. Sits right there in the side pocket, working on the 12-volt power, and it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It works great. And like I said, if somebody calls me, you know, if I happen to be on my bike, I can actually take the call while I'm riding, and it would be going through my speakers and stuff. So it's cool. So I wanted to show that to folks out there that did not know about an FM transmitter. Instead of using the tape thing, a little tape transmitter you can plug in there, or taking this whole unit off and trying to modify the unit to do it, you know. So anyway, that's that. Let me turn this off now. And so those are a couple things I've done so far on my bike. Is I did the headlights and the position lights, or the bulbs turned out great. I got my transmitter, FM transmitter. I'm Bluetoothing now through my motorcycle. Got my phone mount on here. And now let's talk about what I'm out here gonna work on today and get started, because, you know, I'm going to spend this week coming up servicing this bike, doing things on the bike that I want to get done, to where, like I said, stuff hasn't been done since 2013 from the original owner. And I just want to start from ground zero, service the whole dang thing, and then take in and get new tires and wheel bearings at a shop close to my house here. So I've changed the oil, done that so far, but so it's got new oil and filter. So some other things that I'm gonna do to it is whether it needs it or not, because I want to do some things on here because of age. I don't want to be dry. I don't want to be saying, oh well, this thing is working good now, and you know, get out somewhere and all of a sudden, you know, I've got drips, leaks, malfunctions, or whatever. So the stuff that I can do, I'm not gonna do overhaul a bunch of stuff, but little things that I can do that I can fix or go ahead and service, I'm going to. That just didn't cost a whole lot of money. And so I got a list here, and I'm just gonna, you know, so I'm gonna rebuild the petcock. So I got a little kit for that, and a little rubber flange and stuff, and change that out and do that. Service the air filter. This has a K&N air filter. I'm going to clean that and oil it up. I want to rebuild the clutch slave down below, down in there. Rebuild the clutch slave just so I know that it's done. I'm going to flush the clutch fluid, going to flush all the brake fluid. That's all DOT 4 stuff. Going to do all that. I've already drained the two tubes right here. Those the crankcase tubes. There was nothing in it, but if every so often that's a serviceable item, you need to take those plugs out and drain that in case there is any blowback fluid or whatever. I'm going to check the brake pads, although on the service records from the guy that I bought it from, you know, like I said, over 10 years ago, he put brakes on. Well, the brake pads don't even have 1,000 miles on them, so I'm gonna look at them, and if the brake pads still got a good chunk of meat, which I'm suspecting they do, I'm going to keep the brake pads on there. But of course, change all the fluids, brake fluids, clutch fluid, with both of those are DOT 4. I've already changed the headlight bulbs and position bulbs. I bought some gauges to balance the carbs. I want to make sure my carbs are balanced and working properly. I'm going to cruise valve element. I bought this cruise valve element online, so that's a little spongy foam type for the cruise valve element. I'm going to change that, and then these also have a second air filter, or some kind of sub air filter, which is this little foam piece. I can't remember exactly where it sits on the bike. I'm gonna have to search for it, but these are serviceable items, and if these haven't been serviced in years, these, you know, I saw on one guy's video where this thing was just deteriorating. It was, you touched it and it just fell apart. So these little spongy things or foam things, you know, I'm changing them out. I might look at getting the shift pivot support thing to put on there. I might have to look at that. Then I'll lube up any cables I need to lube up. And, so I'm just going to go over, you know, the fluids and filters and, you know, brake stuff and all like that, so I can get the bike up to par. So I know where I'm starting, and then I'm going to get, it needs new tires. So I feel comfortable that the tires are good. The front tire is bald, getting real bald. And the back tire doesn't have any miles on it, but it's several years old. So I'm going to get new tires and have the wheel bearings done at that time. So I know that's all good. But three things that I'm going to wait on. And that one of them is the timing belts. Now, I know, you know, my bike has like 64,000. And the timing belts have not been done. Now, because of age, you know, and so Honda says that they need to be changed every 100,000 miles. Okay. Well, I don't have the mileage, but it's the age, folks. And I'm not saying that it has to be changed that or whatever. And they might not break anytime soon. But because of the age, I'm going to change the belts eventually, real soon. Not before I have the tires and stuff, because I want to get this bike out get this service stuff done that I'm going to do, get to the shop next week or in the next couple weeks and start riding this thing. So June and I can start riding this thing on these beautiful fall days now. You know, here we are in October, spring, Texas, and it's in the 70s now. It's been, you know, over 100 degrees for a month. And over a month, and now it's in the 70s. This is the time when we ride our motorcycles. So I gotta get this stuff done real quick because I don't want to miss these good days and these good weekends anymore. I want to get these bikes, get my bike out on the road. And so I am, after I get the tires and all that thing, get it done where I can drive it, ride it, go on long rides, I am gonna find some time where I can do the timing belts. I've watched several videos. I've got a service manual that I ordered. I've read up on it. I've seen the steps. I'm not missing any steps. I'm well aware how to do this. I'm somewhat mechanically inclined. I don't claim to be a professional mechanic by no stretch of the imagination. But I can turn wrenches. I can do stuff. You know, it might take me longer than some people because I'm OCD and anal about it. But, you know, I'm slow on doing some stuff when I'm at it. But some of this stuff doesn't scare me to do it. So the timing belts, I've seen it done. I watched some videos. I've seen the service manual. It's not that hard. The hardest part is taking all the stuff off up underneath the fairings and all the other stuff to get in there to the belts to do it. But the actual job itself is not that hard, not that technically difficult. So I know how to turn some wrenches. I know how to do stuff. And if you don't know how to do stuff, there's YouTube videos out there. There's forums. There's service manuals. It's not that difficult. Okay. Now I'm not, I'm not a professional mechanic, so I'm not going to go ripping out engines and rebuild engines. No, that I don't do that. You know, I change out parts. I change out service items. I can do that type of stuff. And with that, I'm not going to change the coolant right now or the spark plugs because I read, or when I seen this done, whenever you do the timing belts, you're going to have to drain the coolant and you're going to have to take out the plugs. So why would I want to change the coolant right now or the plugs, before I do the timing belts? Cause I'm sure as hell ain't going to do this twice. So when I do the timing belts in the next few months, after I get some good riding on this thing, I'm going to do the timing belts along with the coolant, along with the spark plugs. So with all the stuff that I'm going to be doing this week, and with those three items a few months down the road, this bike is going to be, in my mind, 100% tip-top shape. I know I've got a base start line. I know what's been done. I know everything's good. So that's what I'm doing this week. And I know I've been babbling and rambling on, and I'm sorry about that, but when you start doing these videos, you know, I don't do a script or anything or have notes prepared or whatever. I just start talking and rambling. So I'm sorry if I rambled on, I'm boring you, but that's what you can put your finger up on the screen and fast forward it or whatever you need to do. So, but the other thing I wanted to mention is that both my bikes are old. The Goldwing is a 97. The Harley is an 03. When you start to get these older bikes, folks, I'm telling you, the dealerships, Honda dealerships and Harley dealerships, don't want to work on older bikes anymore, okay? Luckily, I think the Harleys by my house will still work on my bike, but I haven't taken it to a dealership in quite a while. Because I do all the service myself. I think the last time I took it to an independent shop, but I had the drive belts and all that changed, and not because of mileage, but because of age, because it's a 03. So I spent some money and had some stuff done on that bike that I just wasn't going to attempt to do. But all the normal stuff, spark plugs, oils, fluids, all that, you know, all that kind of stuff, brakes, I'm going to do that myself. But again, let me go back to these bikes. Both my bikes are older, and dealerships are refusing to work on older bikes. Why? Mainly because their techs aren't trained on older bikes. These guys, like in Harley, they're trained on new models, and Harley wants to sell new models. They're not teaching their mechanics, their young mechanics coming out of their trade schools, how to work on these older bikes. So that's forcing us, people like us, to take them to independent shops, work on them ourselves, and then for the stuff that that we're not going to do ourselves, take it to independent shops and have them work on it if we don't want to do something ourselves. Now, on the Goldwing, especially this one, which has, you know, which is, I think this is the biggest Goldwing out of the generations, of all the generations, from a physical size perspective, is the biggest one ever made. Now, shops don't want to work on these independent shops don't want to work on these older Goldwings, and here's why: because of the plastics. Okay, they don't know what condition these bikes are in. People have done work on these bikes, have taken to other shops. Tabs on the plastic have been broke off, plastic's been cracked, things have been done, taking all this stuff apart, on and off, on and off. Parts could be missing, so shops don't want to be liable for, you know, somebody comes in and goes, oh, I noticed my fairing, the tab cracked off when I tried to change my oil or whatever I was doing to my bike, and you did this. Not necessarily. I mean, the bike's old, so no telling when the stuff was cracked, broke, or whatever, and that can't be put on these shops. So I don't blame these independent shops and not wanting to work on this older Goldwing, because I do have a shop down the road about 15 minutes from me that I'm going to take my bike to have the tires and wheel bearings done. And the guy flat out told me, he goes, I don't want to work on Goldwings. We quit working on Goldwings. And I didn't, you know, say, ask him the newer Goldwings, but my generation, when I told him what I had, he goes, he doesn't work on those anymore. Strictly based on the fact of what I just said, because taking this thing apart is a pain in the butt, and you know they're going to get blamed for cracking stuff when it was already cracked, broke, or stuff was missing or whatever, and they just don't want to hassle with it. So, but I said, well, what about tires and wheel bearings? And he goes, yeah, tires, wheel bearings. He goes, that stuff I'll do. He goes, but the engine work or getting it apart, working on the engine, I don't want to do. So then something else popped into my head. I was like, you know, if I get myself in a bind and I can't fix something on this bike, or something major happens that I don't want to work on, I can take all this stuff apart on my bike myself, throw it on a trailer, and bring it to the shop with all the bags taken off, all the fairings taken off. So it's just, you know, so the motor and everything is exposed. Everything's exposed, and the guys don't have to take that stuff off themselves. They can just work on the bike, and then when they're done working on it, I'll bring it back to my house and put the stuff back together myself. So I think if I told that shop that they would agree. Like, okay, we'll do that. That way, you know, the bike is already taken apart and exposed for us to work on. So what I'm thinking about doing when I have the new tires and the wheel bearings changed out is doing just that. Now, when I say I work on my own bikes, you know, I change the fluids, the plugs, all that type of stuff, serviceable stuff. I'm not going to hassle with taking the back tires off the front. I'm not going to hassle with taking the rims and tires off myself and the axles out and the brake calipers off to get all that stuff out of the way and then bring the tires down to a shop and have them mounted and bring that back and put on my... No, I don't want to do that, okay? I would rather have my bike at a shop. They take the rims and tires off, axles out, tighten them up to spec and all that stuff, and put all that stuff back together. So what I'm thinking about doing is I'm going to be working on this bike. So as you can see, I've already got some of the easy plastics off the side that just pull right off. And then because I was working on some other stuff, I, you know, got the bottom stuff off right here. But when it comes time to do tires on the front, I'm going to have to take, you know, this off and this back piece off and, you know, whatever piece has got to come off here to get to the tire. And then, of course, on the back here, I'm going to have to take both bags off the back, this center piece off the back so they can get to the frame and get that frame bar support mount across the back tire there, get it out of the way. So what I'm thinking about is, since I'm doing all this work on my bike already, I'm just going to leave, and I'm checking all these things. I got to drain flush out the brake fluids and all that stuff and check the pads. So I'm going to take the bags and everything completely off this bike, the front stuff, plastics off the front tire, change the fluid, check the brake pads. And then I'm thinking, well, why put this stuff back together just to take it to the shop and have them do the tires and stuff, and then they're going to have to take it apart and put it together. So what I'm going to do is, since I'm already working on it, since I'm already going to have this thing apart, I'm going to do exactly what I just said. I'm going to leave the bike apart with no bags, all the stuff off of it. I'm going to trailer it up to the, because I got a little utility trailer with a ramp on it, and get just strap this bike down, no problem, and drive it up to the shop 15 minutes away, and it's all taken apart. All they got to do is take the rims and wheels off, the axles out, put the tires on, the wheel bearings, you know, and put that stuff back on, and I'll pick the bike up, bring it, put everything back on myself. That way I know that, you know, if that way, you know, I just got the bike, so I need to go over and see what's already cracked on my bike, what might be missing on the plastics, because there might be some broken stuff. And there was on the front part behind the wheel, a little plastic part in the middle that it covers this stuff down here. That cover on the back, it had a little crack in it, and I glued it back together, and kind of fixed it and glued it back together. So I want to go over the whole bike and know about this bike, what might be broke on it, what tabs might be broke, what might be missing, which I don't think there is anything missing or broke too bad, but if there is, I want to know about it, and that's how I'm going to find out. And I don't want to put that on the shop. I don't want to have blame a shop that, you know, if I didn't know something was broken before, I don't want to make false accusations. So again, I'm going to trailer it up there with the whole bike completely taken apart as far as the plastics and the bags and all that. And then they can, that way they have quick access to do the work that I want them to do, new tires, wheel bearings, all that. And then I'll trailer it back to the house and put the damn thing put the thing back together. And once it's all back together, this thing will be good to go for quite a while, because I'm doing all the serviceable stuff right now, and in a few months going to do that timing belts, and then the coolant flush and the spark plugs when the timing belts are done, and then the bike will be ready to enjoy for quite a while with only having to change the oil regularly. So I hope you like this video. And what I had to say, some things I pointed out, the lights, the bulbs, the, you know, headlights and the bulbs, the FM transmitter, hope you might have learned something or got some different ideas, or, you know, maybe you'll save some money instead of getting the top of the line, the so-called top of the line in people's opinion stuff, and just try to, it's all about, you know, lowering cost. I'm not saying use cheap, crappy products, but it doesn't have to be the so-called top of the line name, the name brand that everybody's pushing, or, oh, that's the best. But when there's other stuff out there that's just as good, but cheaper in price. So anyway, I'm going to wrap that this video up, and maybe I'll tag on some other videos and piece these together. As I got the bike apart and I'm doing stuff, I might show a few things again, not step-by-step instructions on how to do stuff, but, you know, occasionally I'll pop in a video, oh, I'm down here, got the seat off, and I'm doing the fuel filters and the air filters and whatever, and kind of string these videos along. Now, that's another thing on that I didn't mention about my channel, is my videos, I keep them simple, okay, guys? I'm not going to do videos and then get on my computer and add music or subtitles or this or that. I'm going to do quick videos that I can do on my phone, just raw video that I can upload, and the extent of my editing is going to be doing, you know, two videos, three, four videos separately as I go along, and I can just splice them together on my phone, put them together, make one video, and then upload it. Just raw video, okay? I don't need all the fancy schmancy subtitles and music, whatever, intros and all that, because I'm not trying to monetize my channel, and I don't care about any of that. I just want my videos to be direct to the point. You know, I don't need all the fluff, don't want all the fluff, not trying to make money on it, not trying to, you know, get user count up necessarily or do any of that stuff. So, other than I do have one video when I took my Harley out this year, Memorial Day weekend, we went to the Hill Country, June and I made a so-called movie that's almost an hour long. Man, that thing took forever. Let me tell you, I did it on the Windows Movie Maker, and I never done that before, and I think that's the last time I'll do that. But I had music and subtitles and strung together multiple videos and pictures, and all. That's one video I have out there on my channel that, yes, I did that, But as far as these other videos that I do, nah, they're just raw video straight from my phone with no professionalism or computer wizardry or whatever, movie maker stuff. And I'm just doing raw video, uploading from my phone and putting it out there for people to watch and enjoy and learn something or get ideas or put nasty comments and about how I need to stop talking about my Harley or, well, your garage is a mess, you lazy bastard, or whatever, or that, oh, you got a C5 vet, that's a piece of crap, you know, you need to get a new vet, what, you can't afford that? I mean, I'm not into any of that, so whatever, you know, it's, I love it when reading other people's channels about comments. Everybody's an expert on the internet, and everybody has an opinion on the internet. I love reading some of these comments on other people's channel, and now that I've got a comment or two on mine, it's kind of funny what people say, but, you know, I got thick skin. It don't bother me. You know, like I say, I just want to put another video out there about, my 1997 SE Goldwing fourth generation that people can enjoy, just people that are into these bikes that they can, see something and watch. And, when they're not busy doing something else and enjoy, because I still get out there on the internet when, you know, I'm laying in bed at night sometimes and I ain't got nothing better going on, can't sleep, I'll get on YouTube and start watching motorcycle videos and different things that people did. So, anyway, I'm babbling and rambling on again, so thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching the video. I'm not going to say like or subscribe or whatever because I ain't into that, but if you want to, that's fine. If you want to put a comment on there, even if you want to bash me, go ahead and do that too, because it'll, you know, I get a good laugh out of it and people start being haters and stuff. Or if you want to just put a nice comment or something cool or say thanks, that's cool too. So again, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching. I'll piece together a couple more videos when I got this bike more apart more, and I'm diving into some things and let y'all see what's going on before I go get the tires on it. So here I am again. I'm not hiding behind a camera. I'm right here in your face. And because on my first Goldwing video, I didn't show my face whatsoever. So anyway, thanks for stopping by. And it's that time of the year to start riding our bikes. The hot summer days are gone. The sweating is done. And it's time to get out there and ride the road on whatever bike you got. Goldwing, Harley, dirt bike, crotch rocket, sport bike, whatever you got. Get out and ride. All right, y'all. Later.